Hi viewer, I welcome you to Erim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Business Studies Form 2, Lesson Number 3. The topic it is Forms of Business Units. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Lesson Objectives. We are going to discuss partnership as a form of business unit. We start by looking at what is partnership. When we talk about a partnership, it's a business unit won by more than one person. It is won more than one person. But it has a limit. It should not go beyond 20. Apart from special cases where a maximum should not exceed 50 people. So you're getting there is a limit of partnership. People who can own a partnership, who can partner together and make a partnership. It limit number it is 20, unless for the special case where we are 15 people. Let us look at the categories of partnership. Partnership may be categorized in either of the two ways. These are the ways. One, according to the type of partner's liability. In this category, a partnership can be general or limited. In general partnership, all members have unlimited liabilities. In this case, the business is unable to settle its debts. A person or set of members can be sworn to clear the debts. This is the what we are referring to it as general or limited partnership. This point now, it means that no partner who has a limited liability. In case now the business is unable to settle its debts, it means that these partners, their personal asset, is the one to be taken in order for it now to clear the debts. While in a limited partnership, members have limited liabilities. And an example, in case the business is unable to settle its debts, personal asset cannot be sold. This is now where now the personal asset is not affected by the business being unable to settle the debts. Although the members can lose the amount of capital contributed to the business. Yes, the amount of money that I contributed to the business, I won't get it by my personal asset, won't be tampered with. That is the time when we have limited liability company or partnership. Now, number two, it can be according to the period of operation. When you talk about the partnership being organized or classified according to the period of operation, can either be temporal or permanent. Now, when you talk about the temporal partnership or joint ventures, that is another name for temporal partnership or temporary partnership, are formed to carry out a specific task for a particular time, after which the partnership is dissolved automatically. So it has a limit time, supposed to be carried out within 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and after that now it is dissolved automatically. Where permanent are formed to operate indefinitely. Permanent, they don't have a specific time when they are supposed to dissolve. It is indefinitely. Now, we look at the types of partners. Now, when you talk about the different types of partners, partners are classified according to role they play. That is one, the role they play, their liabilities, their age, and capital contribution. So those are the four ways in which we classify partners in a partnership. We start with the first one, that is by use of role played by the partners. Partners are either active or dormant. So that is the two classes that we get from the role played by the partners. Active partner is who plays an active role in daily operations of the business. Is active, is doing the daily operations of the business. While passive, or the one who is referred to as dormant, sleeping partner, that is not active, is not doing any operations in the business. Go to the second one, that is by use of their liabilities of their partners. Partners are either limited or general. Limited partner have limited liabilities. This means that those partners, in case the business is unable to settle the debt, their asset, their personal asset is not tampered with. But when I talk about the general, they have the unlimited liabilities. Their assets are tampered with when the partnership fails to clear the debts. Number three, it is the edges. Edges of partners are either minor or major. So when we use the edges of partners, we get minor or major. When I talk about the major, is that person who is above 18 years. And minors, they are those who are aged less than 18 years. So they have the age of less than 18 years. A minor partner cannot participate in management of the business but enjoys the profits. Then the fourth one, it is the capital contribution. Partners may be real or nominal. A real partner is a person who actually contributed the capital into the business. That is a real partner. He contributed his capital into the business. Where a nominal does not contribute directly but allows the partnership to use his name or a name for the purpose of influencing customers or for prestige. You just only allow someone to use your name that you are a member of the partnership. But yet, you have not invested into that partnership business. You can be able to see the different types of partners that we have, and we have classified them into different categories. We have minor partner, active partner, sleeping partner, nominal partner, secret partner, partner by extort, and partner by holding out. Those are the different types of partners that we can have. Then assignment. State four types of partners in a partnership business. If at all you want to refer, get the KLB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you feel like contacting us, you can get us through SMSing us. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Edim TV. Thank you.